Good morning and welcome to our Mass. In today's reading, we see sacramental signs in the Old Testament and how they connect with the sacraments. The ancient Hebrews believed that God's love for them was revealed in signs like water flowing in the desert.
Opening song is number 611. Joyful, joyful, we adore thee.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these beautiful Advent mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Stir up our hearts, O Lord, to make ready the paths of your only beloved Son, Jesus, that through his coming we may be found worthy to serve you with minds made pure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thanks.
A reading from the book of prophet Isaiah. I am the Lord your God who grasps your right hand. It is I who say to you, fear not, I will help you. Fear not, O worm Jacob, O maggot Israel. I will help you, says the Lord. Your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel. I will make of you a threshing sledge, sharp, new, and double-edged. To thresh the mountains and crush them to make the hills like chaff. When you winnow them, the wind shall carry them off, and the storm shall scatter them. But you shall rejoice in the Lord, and glory in the Holy One of Israel. The afflicted and the needy seek water in vain. Their tongues are parched with thirst. I, the Lord, will answer them. I, the God of Israel, will not forsake them.
I will open up the rivers on the bare heights and the fountains in the broad valleys. I will turn the desert into a marshland and the dry ground into springs of water. I will plant in the desert the cedar, acacia, myrtle, and olive. I will set in the wasteland the cypress, together with the plane tree and the pine, that all may see and know, observe and understand, that the hand of the Lord has done this. The Holy One of Israel has created it. The word of the Lord.
Our response: the Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. I will extol you, O my God and King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness.
Let them make known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness.
The Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Amen, I say to you, among those born of women, there has been none greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. From the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent are taken it by force. All the prophets and the law prophesied up to the time of John, and if you are willing to accept it, he is Elijah, the one who is to come. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The Gospel of the Lord. Okay, we'll start with this before we do our reflection. I crunched the numbers, ran them through the computer about 8 times to make sure I had the numbers right. And this is what I came up with. There are only 11 days left to the Advent season. So double check that. I think it is 11 days left to the Advent season. So it's going fast. Oh, good. I'm getting a feedback here. Nonverbal is like, yes, the number is 11. Okay, now I need to ask you, because I'm kind of getting nervous. How many already did their Christmas list? Send it to what, Santa? Oh my. How many are still working on it? How many haven't even started? Oh geez, I'm getting nervous. Okay, I gotta work on that. But I have 11 days. And I also got good news for you. There was a couple days ago, a guy in a red suit, big beard, funny looking hat, said he was Santa. I was like, who? Okay, he's got, you know he's got the naughty nice list, right? No? Yes? Oh, you do? Oh, good. Okay, now he's all high tech now, you know that. Yeah, you knew that. So on one, in one hand, he's got the nice list. It's all computerized, you know, he's got it all on here, and he's scrolling. I said, you know, he's the same. Well, John at St. Wenceslaus. I was like, I know him. And then he was looking, and he goes, well, Mary, she's a student at St. Wenceslaus in Faith Formation. I'm going, yes, I know her. Guess what? All of you made the nice list. You're on the nice list. Santa's nice list. So you're doing, yes, I'm getting some feedback. That's good feedback. And of course, he has his naughty list. And he's scrolling. And he found, guess who's on the naughty list? I am. Father Tim. But he said, I got 11 days to work on this. So, okay, just wanted to pass that by. But to give you good news, you're on the nice list. Okay, so we have these readings in this Advent season, which is only 11 days left. Some beautiful image. I love the image of that first reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 41. God is real. He isn't out there somewhere. He's here with us. And that's what the prophet Isaiah is describing way back to the people of Israel. He's describing how close God is to the nation of Israel. And he writes these words, I am the Lord, your God, who grasps your right hand. I love that image. God's grasping the right hand of the whole nation of Israel. And then he says, I will help you. Grab on. Hang on. And guess what? He does. God does help. Now, it's a rough relationship, but once they grasp God's hand, it's going to go well. It's going to be work, but they'll stay in that relationship. The words tell us from the prophet Isaiah that God wants to be in a relationship, a close personal relationship with you and I. It happens in this Holy Eucharist. It's happening right now. Think of it as God just embracing us with his arms, embracing us with love. God's taking us by the hand and protecting and guiding us on our faith journeys, because it's a crazy world out there. God's reaching out, especially in the sacraments. Grasp his hand, hang on. We'll make it through this crazy world. And then in St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11, Jesus tells the crowds that it's John the Baptist with his own hand who will point out Jesus as the Lamb of God. There he is. Well, we can go over here because now we have the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world in this Holy Eucharist. Jesus, grab on, grasp his hand. So I was trying to think, what does this personal relationship look like in a person's life? In the church, in church history, because we have over 2,023 years of church history. So what does this look like, this personal relationship where God is actually taking the hand of a person, helping them grow in holiness? Well, today is the memorial of Saint John of the Cross, a beloved Carmelite religious. He is a priest and doctor of the church. Doctor of church means whatever we read of his, it's pretty heavy duty stuff. But as you grow in your faith journey, you'll be reading him. And anything we read from a doctor of the church like St. John of the Cross, we're going to grow in holiness. We're going to understand a little better the faith we love. All his writings help us learn and deepen our faith in God. And that's important to read these great saints and their writings. Saint John of the Cross personally experienced what the prophet Isaiah wrote in that first reading. Remember grasping the hand? God grasped Saint John's hand in his faith journey. He was with him. Some of the titles of Saint John of the Cross, some of his works, tell us of this fact. Some of the titles of his works tell us that God and Saint John were walking on this faith journey hand in hand. So here's just a few examples. One of the works is called The Ascent of Mount Carmel. And you'll learn all these things as you continue your faith journey. Another work is The Dark Night of the Soul. Ooh, what's all that about? But don't worry, it's not scary. It may seem scary. Another title is The Spiritual Canticle. That is beautiful. Just the title is beautiful. There's going to be joy there. And then this last one, The Living Flame of Love. I love that title. The Living Flame of Love. God's love for St. John of the Cross. What St. John writes in these works of his is that God's love, his loving presence, saturates every moment of his faith journey. Even those times when St. John of the Cross thought, God has abandoned me. He isn't here. It's so dark. Spiritually, he may be able to see, but on the faith journey, it seemed like God abandoned him, but God didn't abandon him. God's loving presence was saturated in those, especially in those tough moments on a faith journey. It was God who took him by the hand. God reaches out to us with a hand. Grab onto it every day. Don't let go, even on those tough days when you may not be feeling good. Or you're like Father Tim on the naughty list. Hang on. It's going to be good, a good faith journey. So this is a good prayer that we can pray this morning, maybe after communion. We receive communion. It's a very simple little prayer. But it's a good one to pray in these last 11 days of Advent. It goes something like this. Or you can say it in these kind of words. We would pray, God, take me by my hand and help me every day. Isn't that a great prayer? God, take me by the hand and help me every day. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And today, let's stand, and with grateful hearts, let us offer our prayers to the Lord this morning.
For Pope Francis and all of our church leaders, that they will fulfill their calling to celebrate and serve the gospel of life, we pray to the Lord.
We pray that in the Spirit's community, we will show our love, hope, and way through faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life in our parish and city, we pray to the Lord.
For all who are gathered here today, God will deepen our relationship with Christ through the scriptures and the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
For all who care for the sick, especially for frontline workers, may God strengthen and guide them. We pray to the Lord.
For our parish community, that God will take care and fill our hearts with Christ's kindness and mercy in this Advent season. We pray to the Lord.
For those who have died, especially Susan Alexander Abbott, who we are remembering at this Mass, and for all the needs we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
God, in your great love, please hear and answer our prayers this morning according to your wisdom. We ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Our offertory song number 690 on equal space. Number 690.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Please accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make this morning, gathered from among your many gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For Jesus assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope for. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and George our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Oh, well, thank you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Our communion song can be found on the screens, 10,000 Reasons, Bless the Lord.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May these beautiful mysteries, O Lord, in which we have just participated in this morning, profit us, we pray, for even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the living gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. He's coming soon, 11 days. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Our closing song is number 387, O Come Divine Messiah, number 387.
Thank you for joining us at Mass today. This is a prayer for Advent. Lord Jesus Christ, you are the God of love. This second week of Advent, please teach us how to love the way you loved us. Grant us the grace to be loving even to the most unlovable people. Guide us, Lord, to persevere in love. Thank you, Jesus. Please come into my heart. Amen.